Now, if you recall, when we looked at our histogram of signed error, using our guess of 1,451 and a half seconds, we saw that most of the histogram occurs before zero. This suggests that if we adjusted our model just a little bit by perhaps adding an offset, we might be able to improve our accuracy. So let's think about that problem a little bit. So our initial guess of an exponential fit says that our initial guess for the PDF of intertweet times has this form, 1 over beta times e to the power of minus t over beta. And then we found the value of beta, which is most likely to have produced the data that we saw. Now, our insight that we might be able to add an offset means that we're suggesting the model might look something like this instead. And then, in addition to finding a value of beta, we should also look for a value of c that then makes it most likely to have produced the data that we saw. We can actually generalize this to a slightly larger class of exponential models. In addition to a constant c, we can also think about another constant a, where a and c are constants. So what does this mean exactly? Well, we're still trying to solve the same problem. We have a collection of data points describing a histogram, and we're trying to find a curve that best fits it. So previously, we just used beta, and we used the knob of the beta parameter until we found a PDF that best fit the curve. Now, in addition to using the knob of beta, we're going to attempt to use two additional knobs, A and C. And the thought is, can we use the three of these together to get a fit for the PDF which is more accurate? Let's find out. So we're going to use precisely the same method in IPython Notebook to perform a fit. Specifically, we're again going to use SciPy's curve fit in order to find the best parameters. This time, however, fitfunc is going to have a couple of extra parameters. So in addition to just having the constant b, now we're reasoning about the constant a and the offset c. And so fitfunc lets you pass to it, in addition to the independent parameter time, the parameter which we had before, b, but as well as that, a and c. Other than that, it's exactly the same. We're saying to curvefit, we've got this callable function with independent value t and a bunch of parameters, and we're going to feed it these values that I want you to fit to. Now, given that, find me the parameters which best fits those values, and give me the covariance matrix which describes how certain we are about those values. Let's go ahead and do that. So here are the parameters that it came up with for A, B, and C. So curvefit says the value for A is 3.34 times 10 to the negative 1, or 0.334. We have a new B value of 2.172 times 10 to the negative 3, which means in order to get our beta value, we just find the reciprocal of this. And then the offset value, C, is quite small, 3.185 times 10 to the negative 6th, pretty much negligible. So what does that mean? It means that the adjusted model looks something like this. Recall that the generalized form of the adjusted exponential model is a times 1 over beta times e to the power of minus t over beta plus offset c, except that now we have actual values for a, beta, and c. So let's just plug those in. So the result of our new fit looks like this. It says that our new model is approximately 3.34 times 10 to the negative 1 times 2.172 times 10 to the negative 3 times e to the power of minus 2.172 times 10 to the minus 3 times t plus an offset that is nearly zero. So recall that once we've got our model, in order to go from our model to our guess of the number of seconds to wait, we take the expected value of this. So what we want is expected value of intertweet time given that the above is our model. And so if we were to evaluate that, that comes to about 153.83 seconds. So that's to be compared against our initial value of 1,451 and a half seconds, quite a bit smaller. Now let's see how well this new guess of 153.83 seconds works out. So first things first, let's evaluate our adjusted histogram. So just as before, the blue indicates the original intertweet times, and the yellow is the initial exponential fit that we did. To that graph, we've added the red, which is the generalized exponential fit, using the A and C parameters. You can see that it's a little bit of a tighter fit, just sort of qualitatively. Now, let's form a histogram of the signed error for our updated guess of 153.83 seconds. So again, here, we're collecting signed differences, and absolute values of differences, just now for our updated guess instead of the original guess. So we see that the mean of the absolute error has decreased to 1,401 seconds from 4,446.8 seconds as it was before. So it's gone down quite a bit. In addition to that, we've gone from being within about 1,437 seconds 75% of the time to being within 676 seconds 75% of the time of the actual intertweet time. So that's saying that with our adjusted model, we're good to within about 11 minutes 75% of the time, which is actually not terrible given that we still don't really know anything about the dynamics of the problem. So before we proceed, let's just summarize where we are. So we decided to build a regression estimator to estimate the number of seconds since the last tweet. We decided to model this regression estimator using an exponential fit. Our initial fit suggested always guessing 1,451.5 seconds. After forming some confidence bands on this value of beta, and taking a look at the absolute and signed error, we decided we want to take a step back and look at a slightly more generalized version of that model, with a greater number of parameters. After fitting the new generalized model, we came to a new guess of 153.83 seconds and discovered that it performed a bit better than the initial fit. Now, in the next few videos, we're going to dig deeper into this data and the dynamics of the problem as we do a more formal investigation.